going on, everybody? This is 40B Nasty. I'm here to show you an update on my tank. I still have my cyanobacteria. I did do a few things. I changed the pulse on my power heads, which has been pretty good because it's been lifting it up off the sand bed a little bit better. I'd like to talk about the SW4, the J-Bow SW4s. They did come out with a new series. I believe it's the OW4s. They do have a PB4 and RW4 or a WR4. I can't remember which one it is, but they are a great cheap wave maker. And this stuff is good for your corals as far as like giving it a nice bounce or pulse, you could say. It's great for gas exchange. Before, I had this thing kind of whipping around too much. I'll tell you what, that's not good for this soft flesh on these things. Like, look at that. My torch right there, this guy, he was getting pushed around way too hard. Now I'm keeping it nice and lifted, and the coral's a lot healthier looking, honestly, since I did it. I moved this frog spawn down there. He's been taken care of over there, just looking really nice, getting bushed out again the way I liked it. And it also helps kick the detritus up off the ground. My fish obviously do not mind it. You can see my mandarin, you know, pulsing around or whatever, doing his thing. Everybody's kind of just chill. But here's one other thing I wanted to show you as far as the update. I ended up picking up this little guy at the store the other day. He has been a little terror to the bottom of my tank. He is building himself a home now, finally. He was over there trying to take over the Antheus's sleeping spot underneath that little rock over there. And he came up and around back and he started sleeping under the air stone that I had over there, which was like a small circular flat plate. And I was like, I don't want you thinking this is going to be your home. So, and then he decided to go up underneath here and take over my Gramicoline darfish. Well, that's my Gramicoline darfish. Don't mess with him. And then I pushed him over with a turkey baster. And now he's out, and he keeps, I don't know why he didn't just go over like 2 extra inches. I had the whole dugout for him there. I had a whole dugout there for him with right in there. I took like a 3/8 siphon tube, and I basically just sucked it real quick, pulled the sand out, and then I just dumped it all right back into the tank up top, and let it all fall back down. I made a nice little hole, so if you're ever looking for an idea to make a hole underneath a rock, and you know you got a good little spot for it, that's how you do it. So that's a nice little tip. But this guy, you know, they are jumpers. They are the biggest jumpers actually out there in the hobby, I heard. So be careful when you go to buy one of these, because you will dump money down the drain so fast with these guys. All jawfish are like this. You know, gobies are like this. Wrasse are like this. Even the darkfish, when they get spooked, they don't go down, they go up sometimes. And luckily I have not had that problem with mine. And he's been just kind of building away, doing his thing. I'm waiting for him to find China over here. But here's some of the things I had to do while this guy was in the tank. I had to run out to Home Depot real quick, have somebody watch my tank, make sure he did not jump. Because all I had was the glass top, which I'm going to show you real quick. I've always had the glass top. I actually had it off for oxygen, better gas exchange when I was doing that cyanobacteria with the red slime remover, because it exhausted my tank. And, well, this is what I did. I bought this one slat right here. Well, it was all one. I still actually have an extra chunk out there. It was about 7 feet long. And I just cut it into 2 sections. In the middle, you can see the same width as the glass. And then all I did was measured from the back out a little bit. It was about 2 inches for each piecing. So I just markered up 2 inches, which is right here on the third lat, you could say. And then I just cut it with a skill saw, boom, boom, or jigsaw, whatever you call those things. I'm not like the most power tool knowledgeable guy, but that's what I used. I know how to use them. And this is what I did. I cut a bunch of slats in it. And I'll tell you what, it's not that bad when I saw all the perforations were there. $7. I couldn't go wrong to save a fish that cost way more than $7, you know. And plus, you know, then I have the security. But the only thing I have to do is tidy up these holes, because these are places that they will find You gotta be careful of that. You are not safe. Like, even in this little spot, he can find that. I've had a random prong goby jump out because of all that. I'm not worried about my lights, as you can see, off the reflection. There's my actinic, my blue plus, coral plus, and blue plus. They're all going straight down like this. I got plenty of light on my corals. You don't really have too many corals in the back, usually. I do have a few up top, like the Fruit Loops. They look like garbage anyway, so I'm not worried about it. I can never find a home for them. I tried to. I said, this is where you're staying. I got sick and tired of moving around. And I'll tell you what. Hopefully he stays in. Hopefully I don't run into that problem of finding a carpet surfer in the morning with him. He's digging his little hole still. Cute little guy. He's smart too. Really personable. He's already eating, which is great. Make sure you get an eating at the store, because if they're not, there's not a good chance of survival rate. I've heard some, you know, bad stories about these guys, but if you do them right, I think you're not going to have a problem. And when they get introduced into a tank, they're going to let everybody know, don't mess with me. They really have a big mouth, and they will open up and show every single fish in your tank what he's got. And him and the Flame Angel actually kind of bumped heads when they started off. Not so much any other fish, but I'll tell you what, it also actually reduced the aggression towards the Antheus from the Flame Angel. So hopefully that is the cure for that. Will it be? I doubt it, you know, with my luck. Well, anyway, this is 40B Nasty out. I'm going to get back to watching my little guy take care of his new home. And hopefully he makes it underneath, and I'm going to push all that sand over and block him back off in there. This is 40B Nasty out. Take care.